have put our hope in your word. Psalm 119, verse 147, we rise before dawn and cry for help. We have put our hope in your word. You know, no matter how difficult life becomes, we belong in families. There may be times when we let down those we love most and fail people who we care for so very much. But through it all, we discover this group of people who make us feel that we belong, who say, what happens to you matters to me. Thus, we stand together and face all of life with a confidence born of a sure identity, the position we hold in our family. In spite of the pain, in spite of the frustration, and in spite of embarrassment at times, the world of life in the family is still totally God's gift. The caring nurture and confidence that comes from being seen at our worst and still knowing that we belong and are loved is God's gift to us. It is a place where we can love one another all the time, through it all. It's a place where we see his power and his grace demonstrated over and over again. This is my family. This is my family. God created and knit us together, himself. So as we rise and get together in prayer, let's remember that we are completely blessed being in this position where we have people who care for us, who bless us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for this morning. We are placing it before you, this time of prayer. We know you will bless us abundantly. In the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
With your presence, you alone are worthy of our reverence. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, serve the Lord, we will serve the Lord.
Lord, we vow to live holy, bowing our knees to you only. As for serve the Lord, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord.
Trusting in God's word, we need each other. Father,
Today's Bible reading is from the book of Job, chapter 2, verses 1 to 13. On another day, the angels came to present themselves before the Lord. And Satan also came with them to present himself before him. And the Lord said to Satan, "Where have you come from?" Satan answered the Lord, "From roaming throughout the earth, going back and forth on it." Then the Lord said to Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He is blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil. And he still maintains his integrity, though you incited me against him to ruin him without any reason." "Skin for skin," Satan replied, "a man will give you all he has for his own life. But now stretch out your hand and strike his flesh and bones, and he will surely curse you to your face." The Lord said to Satan, "Very well then, he is in your hands, but you must spare his life." So Satan went out from the presence of the Lord and afflicted Job with painful sores from the soles of his feet to the crown of his head. Then Job took a piece of broken pottery and scraped himself with it as he sat among the ashes. His wife said to him, "Are you still maintaining your integrity? Curse God and die." He replied, "You're talking like a foolish woman. Shall we accept good from God and not trouble?" In all this, Job did not sin in what he said. When Job's three friends, Eliphaz the Temanite, Bildad the Shuhite, and Zophar the Naamathite, heard all about the troubles that had come upon him, they set out from their homes and met together by agreement to go and sympathize with him and comfort him. When they saw him from a distance, they could hardly recognize him. They began to weep aloud, and they tore their robes and sprinkled dust on their heads. Then they sat on the ground with him for 7 days and seven nights. No one said a word to him, because they saw how great his suffering was. May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of his word.
We do not have answers for all our questions. We do not have an explanation for all our experiences. Job went through the trauma of listening to his friends who spoke as if they were God's spokespersons. You know, when his friends arrived, their best ministry to him was the first 7 days. In the passage that was read to us, verse 13, it says, "And they sat with him on the ground 7 days and seven nights, and no one spoke a word to him." I think that was the best moment in Job's life, when they kept silent and never spoke anything. Because the moment they opened their mouths, they brought further hurt to Job. You know, they were adding to Job's pain over and over again. And I'm sure that you would have gone through it. There are some who are insensitive to the pain that we go through, and they speak as if they have an explanation for all of our pain and suffering. And the more they interpret it, the more it hurts. The first of the three friends, Eliphaz, acknowledges that Job has been a source of strength. That's how he started in Job chapter 4, verse 3 and 4. But then he turns and puts the blame for Job's suffering squarely on Job himself. He said, "Job, you are the reason for your suffering. Think now," he says, "who that was innocent ever perished?" In other words, he's saying, "Job, you're not innocent, Job. You're facing the consequences of what you've done." Job's second friend, Bildad, says much the same. He said, "See, God will not reject a blameless person, nor take the hand of evildoers." Job chapter 8, verse 20. The third friend, Zophar, he repeats the refrain, "If iniquity is in your hand, put it far away. Do not let wickedness reside in your tents." You know, friends, you and I are most vulnerable when we are going through pain, uncertainty, struggles in life. Even the ones who really care for us sometimes say words that hurt us, saying, "I know why you're going through it." They speak as if they have received straight word from the Lord, and it hurts over and over again. And when we are in that stage, we tend to believe our friends. Job did not know the conversation God had with Satan. But you and I know to a certain extent the ways of God. We have the word of God. We do not know all of God's ways. But when we read the word, the Lord ministers to us and we draw strength. How we wish our answer to our questions are like the customer care service. Press 1 if you are sick. Press 2 if you're going through financial loss. Press 3 if you want to talk to our executive. Praise God, he has not prepared that kind of a call center. All that he says, call upon me in the days of trouble. There is a direct contact. You and I can call upon him 24/7. He's the Lord who is available to listen to my cry, to listen to my pain, to listen to my anxiety, to listen to my foolishness, to listen to whatever I have to say. He never rejects. He listens, because the Bible says we have a high priest who sympathizes with us just as we are this morning, my friends. Praise God for this wonderful time of prayer as a family. Coming from different backgrounds, different language groups, come together. The common ground is, Lord, it is you and you alone. The Lord has made it simpler for us to call upon him. If this is the promise, call upon me in the days of trouble and I will answer you. Why, Lord, it is taking so much of time? The answer is in Job chapter 1, verse 8. The Lord said to Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He is blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil." The Lord was, it was not Satan who asked for Job. It is the Lord who said, "Have you tried Job? Look at the conflict." The Lord is saying, test him. Try. And I will prove to you that this servant of mine, Job, is strong enough to stand. And I believe that the Lord puts some of us through that furnace and sits there and say, "Don't worry, my daughter." I always believe this, friends. The Lord never pushes us into the valley. The Lord accompanies us into the valley. He walks with us. He talks with us. He comforts us. And that is why Job is saying, "I know my Redeemer liveth." In the midst of discouragement, in the midst of all these negativism, he stands firm. How was it possible for Job to wait till the end? There are four things. Let me quickly highlight and then move on. The first thing, Job never allowed negative words to weaken his faith. He never allowed negative words to weaken his faith. And this morning, you will be surrounded by negativism. You may see things that are not working towards the plan of God in your life. Friends, don't just worry. Hold on. Keep saying, "I know my Redeemer liveth. I know the Lord whom I believe. He said, call upon me in the days of trouble and I will answer." He never allowed negative words to weaken his faith. The second thing you find here, he persevered in his knowledge of God. He never allowed people to pull, to hurt, to destroy his conviction. His understanding of God, he held on. Even when his wife said, "Curse God and die," he said, "Should I accept only good things from God?" This morning, your understanding of God and my understanding of God is sufficient for us to walk through boldly and say, He is Jehovah Jireh, he is Jehovah Shalom, he is Jehovah Rapha, he is God Almighty, he is a prayer answering God, he is a promise keeping God. The knowledge of God, persevere in it. The third thing you find here, Job did not let his affliction affect his worship. He did not let his affliction. He continued to worship the Lord. Let's not allow our discouragement, our disappointment to hurt us. Early in the morning, I will rise up, O Lord, even before the darkness, even before it's the day starts. In Psalm 19, verse 14, Moses so beautifully says, O Lord, fill me early in the morning with your loving kindness, early in the morning, because I do not know the days, and I do not know how it's going to be. But Lord, when you fill me with loving kindness, if you fill me with that love, that is enough for me to go through the day. He did not let his affliction affect his worship. The fourth thing you find here, he verbalized his feeling to the Lord. Whatever his friend said, he took it to the Lord in prayer. Who is the first one that you and I will run to? Even our unspoken words, Lord, you listen. Even my tears, you interpret. I have swallowed many tears, Lord. This morning I've come to you. And I know you're the only one who will understand. You know, friends, the place of waiting has got these three things. The place of waiting is the place of testing. The place of waiting is the place of trusting. The place of waiting is the place of triumph. Remember these three T's. Remember these three T's. It is a place of testing, it is a place of trusting, and it is a place of triumph. There is a purpose in God making us wait. It's part of discipleship. Abraham waited, Joseph waited, David waited, Noah waited, God himself waited, and Jesus too waited. And this morning, waiting is not wasting. Waiting is investing in the economy of God and saying, Lord, I will wait. Let your will be done. But the time that I wait, Lord, strengthen me, strengthen my faith, enable me, Lord, to walk. He is a promise-keeping God. May the Lord continue to strengthen us even as we wait upon him.
As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. The second portion of the book of Joshua, chapter 24, verse 15. Shall we all say it together? As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As we get together to pray, let us make a fresh commitment to the Lord. Many of us here in this group have prayed for our daughter Kavya as she went through that difficult time in May, earlier this year. And I'm going to ask her to just say a few words explaining, giving her testimony about how it was just prayer and prayer alone that brought us through that valley of the shadow of death itself.
I'd like to share my experience with our unchanging God. As my father mentioned, the second wave of COVID hit us hard. My brother and sister tested positive for COVID in the beginning of April, followed by my Appa and Amma. Amma was admitted in hospital for over a week. God has been so faithful, and I'm so overwhelmed by his goodness. My husband and I were hit with COVID the last. On the 10th of May, My saturation began to drop below 90 even while I was using an oxygen concentrator. Our family in Vellore said that I needed to be admitted immediately. Blood reports and a chest x-ray at the first hospital that we went to showed that I had severe COVID pneumonia with possibly irreversible damage to the lungs. They said that I'd need an ITU bed, but there wasn't a single bed available at every hospital that we tried for that evening. After rushing to two other hospitals, I was moved to the ITU at 2 a.m. with only a non-rebreathable mask. There was a divine peace and a strength that cloaked us almost physically like a mantle of protection. I was protected by a shield of projected courage in the midst of an atmosphere of death and darkness that surrounded me. I had an army of prayer warriors storming heaven's gates on their knees both day and night, pleading for my life. The night of May 13th was my darkest. I was afraid to even turn in my bed because I would begin to cough and then struggle for air. The blinding white light kept turning on and off. I watched as some patients went into the ICU from the ITU. I watched as bodies of patients who had succumbed were wheeled out, and I lost my strength to fight. It was in that moment of absolute and complete surrender that God took over. Within 2 hours, the doctor walked in and changed the complicated mask that I was wearing to simple nasal prongs. She said I was able to breathe with just 4 liters of oxygen. I was responding well to the medication, and they would shift me to the ward as soon as a bed was available. It was in that moment of hopelessness that His glory came through. The doctors were amazed with the progress. They hadn't seen anything like this. In less than the critical 72 hours, I was moved to the ward with just 2 liters of oxygen. My life is a testimony to the fact that we serve a God of miracles. Every day is a miracle, every breath a chance to worship Him for all that He has done. So let us not weary of hearing and experiencing darkness all around. Let us continue to plead for His saving power to enable His dearest children to see His goodness. Every stronghold shall be broken, for He alone wears the victor's crown.
I am not ashamed. I have the power of the Holy Spirit. I have stepped over the line. The decision has been made. I am a disciple of Jesus. I won't look back. I won't let up. I won't slow down. I won't back away. Together, let's make a few decisions today. Together, let us promise God and ourselves that we're going to be different. My past has been redeemed. My present makes sense. My future is secure in the Lord. The Lord's presence is here, and it's His anointing that's going to help us make these decisions today. No more low living, no more colorless dreams, no more small visions, no more worldly talks, and no more short goals, dwarfed goals. The Lord is going to help me through and through. I am not in it for promotion. I'm not in it for position, for popularity, or for power. I realize that I don't need to be first. I don't need to be recognized. I don't need to be praised. I know what I am. And my connect and understanding comes from God and God alone. I have decided to follow Jesus. I don't need to be regarded or rewarded. I now live by faith, and faith alone leaning on this presence of His that is enveloping me. I'm walking by patience. I'm uplifted by this prayer. And I know that prayer alone will see me through. Friends, it's been a great time that we've been spending together, rising early in the morning to spend time with Him. It's time we let go of the petty situations that have chained us down. Let go. Drop it. It's not worth it. A life is too precious for anything to mess us up. It's a glorious life that He has given us. Just keep saying goodbye to things that don't matter. So together, let's do that now, at this moment. If you're holding on to past hurts and pains, drop it. Let it go. Let it go. If it takes forgiving, forgive. You have nothing to lose. In the name of Jesus, forgive. If someone just does not treat you right, or love you back, or see your worth, let it go. Let it go. Just forgive. Drop it. If someone has angered you, let it go. If you're holding on to thoughts of evil and revenge, don't. Forgive. Let it go. If you're involved in a wrong relationship, or addiction, drop it. Let it go. If you're holding on to a job that no longer meets your joy, meets your satisfaction, and your talents, let it go. God has a different plan. If you've been trying to find a purpose and a reason, this is the reason. God has a different plan. If you're struggling with the healing of a broken relationship, let it go. Let it go. Drop it. And if you're trying to help someone who won't even try to help themselves, just stop it. That's enough. You have tried enough in the name of the Lord. Let it go. If you're feeling depressed and stressed, check out what it's all about. Have the strength to go to the Lord in prayer on your knees, and let's together bless Him and let it go. If you're trying to chart out a way, a path, a direction on your own without God, don't. Don't. He is our ideal master planner. The blueprint is with Him. Leave it to Him. Let the past be the past. Forget the former things. God is doing a new thing in us, in prayer and in prayer. There's no other answer to any of our situations, good, bad, everything In joy, pray. In sorrow, pray. In difficulty, pray. In suffering, pray. In every situation, every single situation, pray, because all you're doing is talking to the one who gave us life, who gave us breath. The battle is the Lord's. Leave it to him. Quickly, let's pray for our health, our finances, our work life. His presence is so very much here. So don't waste this opportunity, please. Let's just bless the Lord. Your family, your relationships, all of our other prayer requests. This is the moment. Let's get together quietly in silence for the next couple of minutes, bringing us all to the Lord in prayer. Just maybe a total mess of many things, but doesn't matter. His presence is here. Bring it to the Lord, to the foot of Calvary at this time, at this moment. I now live by faith. I'm leaning on his presence. I'm walking in total patience as I wait upon him for his perfect timing. I know that I'm uplifted by prayer and prayer alone. Let us pray.
Father God, we thank you this morning for your faithfulness. We want to thank you, Lord, for having led us throughout these 21 days. We want to thank you that you allow us to come to your feet. And we want to thank you, Lord, this day that it is the most comforting place we could find ourselves in. Lord, we acknowledge, God, that you are supreme, worthy of worship, worthy of praise, worthy of all of our lives and being entrusted in your hands. Lord, this morning we want to thank you that you have not changed. You remain steadfast in your everlasting love. You continue to give and you continue to care. You continue to care about the smallest details of our life. Lord, we want to thank you that you're a God who cares about our welfare and never plans a destruction for us. But Lord, this morning we come before your throne of grace. We want to thank you, Lord, that you reminded us today that this is a place where you take us through trials to test us, to enable us to trust you, and to, Lord, to come out victoriously, triumphant because of your precious Son in our lives, O God. Lord, we throw ourselves on the court of your mercy. We acknowledge, O God, that we need you every day of our life, in fact, every hour of our life. We want to thank you that you are available. And no matter what we do in your presence, it never weakens nor tires you, because you care. You care when we go through difficult times. Lord, this morning we plead with you, God, give us strength never to be allowed to let negative words to weaken our faith in your presence, O God. Give us a desire to persevere in your presence, Lord, in the knowing of who you really are. For you are a steadfast, almighty, all-knowing, all-present God. We want to thank you, Lord, that our afflictions are not going to be the end of things, God. We want to thank you that you will enable us to continue to worship you even in the midst of our afflictions. And God, we want to thank you this day that your spirit will walk with us through the valley of the shadow of death, O God. We want to thank you this day that you will enable us to verbalize our feelings in your presence, O God, that through our prayer. And just as we heard this morning, Lord, we thank you that you've given us this liberty to talk to you personally. Lord, please, Lord, help us. Help us to remember that you're waiting as much as we are to hear us cry out to you. There is nothing so big that you will not pull us through or take us through. And therefore, Lord, this morning, in all humility, in childlike faith, we come before your throne of grace and we plead with you and say, Lord, help us. Help us to with our health issues, Lord. Help us, Master God, with our finances. For you are Jehovah Jireh. You provided even times when we didn't even care. We want to thank you, Lord, that the work that you've given us in our work life, you will govern for us, O God, because you see the end from the beginning. Father, we want to entrust our family into your hands. Thank you for providing us a family. Thank you, Lord, for even giving us a friend to belong to. Thank you, Lord, for giving us people within the house and the body of Christ that care for us, that pray for us, that pursue your kingdom, your presence, Lord, for us. We want to thank you, Lord, that you're willing to envelop us with your precious love in all possible forms of God. We want to thank you this day for relationships that you've given us, whether they be broken, whether they be strained, whether they be going through difficult trials of God. We want to thank you that our relationship in you, Lord, will never sever because of your covenant with us, O God. Lord, we want to thank you this day. Thank you for everything you've given us, Master God. We thank you that you stand with us even at this moment and understand us. We want to thank you this day that we can completely surrender to your love that is so pure, so holy. And in your holiness, God, there is no intent to harm us. We give you glory and honor and praise. We rest in your presence. We bring ourselves to be still and know who you are. We kiss your feet this morning. We thank you, Master God, for listening to every word that proceeded, came from our mouths. That every groan you heard about us from our heart, O God, for watching every tear that dropped out of our eyes. And we ask of you this day that you be glorified in our lives, in and through the precious name of your Son, our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. 21 days. We have been together. I know that there are quite a few people who have been here for all the 21 days. It would be wonderful if you could either put up your hand or just mention it in the chat box, and we would really be excited to acknowledge you. We really want to thank you for giving us this opportunity of getting all of us together. 21 memory verses we should be knowing by now. We will be posting all of them in the group, so please try and see that we know that. What has been decided is that we will meet every Monday morning at 6 o'clock every week. For starters, we will meet on Monday mornings, and then we will take a call about other things later. But next Monday, we will be meeting at 6 o'clock. If you have testimonies about the last 21 days, please send it in. We have a very special testimony from a friend, Suresh Matthew, who has been with us, whose prayers were answered. And then it was beautiful that he started ministering to people in the rooms, in the breakout rooms. We also want to let you know that you can keep sending in your prayer requests directly or in the group. And we'll definitely be praying for any situation that is there. The group will continue. We also want to remind you that the prayer journal you need to maintain. Please don't let up on this. Wake up in the morning and try and pray for these things. All these things have been sort of, we have discussed ACTS, adoration, confession, thanksgiving, supplication. But it doesn't mean that. It just means talk to God, full stop. The recordings of all the days are there available in the group. If anyone wants it sent to you directly, please let us know. But otherwise, it's been a great time. We have been blessed. We have been totally blessed. There have been breakthroughs. There have been situations where prayers have been answered. We have testimonies coming in. And those who would like to send us something more, please feel free to do that anytime. We bless you. We bless the Lord. And let's praise Him for this wonderful time. There will be breakout rooms now, those who would like to stay back and pray in the presence of God, please do that. Thank you very much.
Your love, O Lord, is strength to my soul.
with your presence. You alone are worthy of our reverence. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord.
Lord, we vow to live holy, bowing our knees to you only. Serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord. Staying together, praying together, any storm we can weather.
We need each other for the
Oh, Don't face these troubles alone. Even in the valley, God Just give me your presence. Some people try to listen to the bottom of a bottle. Some people try to listen to a needle in their arm. Some people try to listen to the money in their pocket. Some people try to listen to another's arms. You and I are not that different. We got a void and we're just trying to fill it up. Something that will give just a little peace. All we want is a hand to reach to. Open arms and say,
lose the strength to carry on. You and I are not that different. We got a void and we're just trying to fill it up. Something I will give just a little piece. All we want is a hand to reach to. Open arms and say I love you.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. is still God in the night.